Chairman. Let me recognize Mr. Nirvan Maharaj. President General of the All Trinidad Union. I want to also recognize Mr. Basdev Pandey. And if you will indulge me, I will have to say something about that. I am here this morning because I came to Rienzi a few days ago. And in having discussions with Mr. Maharaj and so on, he recognized the fact that the time has come when those who depended upon the sugar industry must begin to speak with one voice. You see, a small voice is not enough for this government to hear. And you must recognize that. Former sugar workers and cane farmers, you must recognize that. You must speak with one voice. That is why I took the opportunity to come here today to articulate our position, and of course that of all the dependents of the sugar industry. And ladies and gentlemen, let me say that we must not forget. We must never forget those who struggled for us over the last 40 years to bring about economic well-being, not only for the sugar workers, but for the cane farmers, those who depended upon the sugar industry. We must not forget that. And in this regard, I want to mention one Mr. Basdev Pandey. When you and I were in the dumps, we were divided in Trinidad and Tobago. Through the sugar industry, Mr. Basdev Pandey came forward and provided leadership for us. And ladies and gentlemen, we must not forget that. We must never forget that. Whatever our feeling or our information is, we must never forget those of us who laid the foundation for you to be here today. But the struggle continues. Ladies and gentlemen, you know the time is around when we go around with a jacket and tie praising those of our forefathers who came to Trinidad and Tobago. How much they endured, how much they suffered, because they came here to bring a better life for their families in India. They came here with the intention of working and bringing about a better life. But ladies and gentlemen, you and I, the remnants of the sugar industry today, are being sidelined, marginalized, and not being recognized for the contribution that we have been making to Trinidad and Tobago. And we must let them know that we, through your parents and foreparents, built this country when sugar was king. Your parents, you did, and those of us who remain here are looking forward for a better life for us and our families. What do you see, ladies and gentlemen? What do you see? And let me use this language. When the industry was closed, when you were sent home in 2003, it was a brutal attack on the sugar industry. And I must say that, a vicious attack, not on the sugar industry, but those who depended upon the sugar industry. It was a vicious attack on the economic well-being of not only the sugar workers, but the cane farmers. We were scattered then. And today, farmers, sugar workers, 13 years later, we continue to struggle. What are we struggling for? We are struggling for a better life. We are struggling for the resources that will enhance our economic well-being. I could understand the previous administration, whether it was malicious, whether it was politics involved. We suffered at their hands. And today we raise our hands to this administration. I make no apologies for that, you know. We all raise our hands. 8,000 sugar workers. There are 9,000 cane farmers and their workers outside there whose voices are not being heard. 20,000 of us raising our hands to this administration to address our issues. And what do we get? Nirvan will tell you to run around. Meeting after meeting. Prime Minister, Minister here, Minister there, and at the end they say, pull something and continue for the next 2-3 years. Is that what it is? Is that the benefit? Is that the payback that we get what is it, remaining in this sugar industry? Is that what we get? Ladies and gentlemen, begin to think here today, you know, and search your soul and your family. Those of you who are not here today and who are listening on the outside, think carefully what we are saying to you today. You know. 50 years after you were sent home, you are still struggling, still begging and raising your hands to this administration. Please give us what is ours. We're not asking for anything more. All we are asking for, ladies and gentlemen, is what we deserve. That's all we are asking for. And sugar workers, farmers who are here, we must learn to speak with one voice. That is why I am here today. We must begin to articulate our position very, very clearly to this administration, that we put them there also. Are we politically insignificant so they can just dismiss us and having us run meetings here and there all over this place? No. We, through your leaders, must speak with one voice, and we must get your support wherever you are. That is what the message I am bringing here today to all of you. The time has come, sugar workers. The time has come. Cane farmers, your families, begin to understand what transpired in 2003, you know. It was a vicious attack on your economic well-being, you know, to destroy you, you know. As I said, if it's political, we don't know, I don't know. But to destroy you, destroy your will, your political will to fight. That is what has happened. So, sugar workers, I just want to quickly deal with one issue that I came here to deal with. That is the cane farmers issue. And you have been hearing me, seeing me, taking up this fight, continuing this fight. I want to say very clearly here today that the basis for the cane farmers' compensation is not this government. The basis and funding for the cane farmers' compensation is coming by regulations from Brussels, the European Union, European Commission, of which you hear about. And it is very clear, it is very, very clear that the government does not have to put one red cent into the cane farmers' compensation package. It is also very clear that the nature of the cane farmers' issue, the government can now go back to the European Commission and ask for more money to satisfy the compensation to the cane farmers. Ladies and gentlemen, you have been hearing a lot of things on the outside. You have been hearing a lot of things. We have been having a lot of dialogue. When we got the opportunity, there was no compensation package in place, and we put one together with the help of the European Commission's funding and so on. We put it together, submitted it to the government and the European Commission. In 2012, the Minister of Agriculture stated publicly that they collected $300 million. He said they spent it, but they have $300 million to come, and they will ensure that the money is used to satisfy this document for the cane farmers. You know what we are hearing now? All they have available is 3 million euros. All they have available is 3 million euros. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean, like all of you will ask, where did the money go? Where did it go? There is an agreement between the European Commission and the government of Trinidad and Tobago that is very, very clear that this money is protected from fraud and corruption and mismanagement. I'm asking the question, where is the funding for our compensation package? Dr. Tiwari has written to me a month ago that our issue is on the table for discussion and so on. Up till now, he has not responded. We're calling, we're writing and so on. He has not responded at all. Has Dr. Tiwari gone silent on this matter? Do they have any funding to begin the process of compensating the cane farmers? I don't know, I'm asking the question. And I'm sure all cane farmers in this country will ask the very same question. What has happened to their money? So ladies and gentlemen, we continue the fight. We continue to ensure that the money that was given to the government of Trinidad and Tobago by agreement is used for the purpose for which it is intended. I have written to the European Commission just last week asking the people who are putting the money into this compensation package to address this matter with the Minister of Planning and of course get back to us. We have not had any word. I do not expect to hear from the European Commission directly, but I would hope that the European Commission is listening, that they cannot allow this amount of money to go down the drain where the prime beneficiaries of this money, the keen farmers, are now questioning what has happened to the resources that have been made available to us. Ladies and gentlemen, that money, just like the sugar workers' exit package, is to deal with the issue of social and economic support programs to help you to move on. Today, 15 years after, we are still moving on. The damage, I am saying it today, if it was deliberate, I am saying that the damage has been done to the remnants of the sugar industry, the sugar workers and the cane farmers. That is why we are here today. That is why you are here today. The damage to yourselves, and you may not see it, the damage to your family. Not only economic damage where you're struggling for land to produce food for your family and so on, but the social damages where you could not support your children and your grandchildren. You could not support the financial commitments you had, just like the cane farmers. They are suffering now. They have loads of commitments that they cannot support. Those are the consequences of the closure of the sugar industry. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to say once more, this struggle will continue. I am disappointed in the way that this administration is handling this matter. It's close to 5 years we have been talking with them. Close to 5 years, ladies and gentlemen. And they are dragging, for whatever the reason, they continue to drag this issue. Just like the sugar workers, they continue to drag. I would have expected this administration to come up front and say what the issues are. And they now must come out and say they will deal with your matter expeditiously. You deserve your land, whatever support you deserve, that this administration will give it to you in the shortest possible time. What do you see? You must understand that the government can do whatever they want. If they choose to do something, no one can stop them. And Mr. Pato will attest to that. They can give you what is yours, they can give the king farmer what is theirs. Let us go. But farmers, sugar workers, my appeal to you and to those of you who are listening on the outside, that we must begin to speak with one voice. It's not 5,000, 6,000. 20,000 of us plus our families, close to 100,000 people, must learn to speak with one voice. You support us, we will take this fight, witness and Ramaraj, all the way on your behalf. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you.
Thank you very much, Brother Tambie. Let me remind you that we are carrying this broadcast live to 97.5 Hot Like Pepper. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to remind you of some of the issues that we have been dealing with over the past 2.5 years. My dear brothers and sisters, your sweetener loan, we had negotiated, and I would have fed up said that before, in principle, with the leader of government business, with Mr. Basan Ba, Mr. Suruj Rambachan, and other ministers, we had agreed on your sweetener loan, and all calculations has been given to the Ministry of Finance, and we are still awaiting on a date to pay. I want you to remember, Madam Prime Minister, that on the 27th of July 2013, you made that commitment in Karisabanalo Pier Road in the Shogunas West by-election, and we are calling on you to pay that Sitna money to the 3,150 people of the ex-Karani Workers Association. My dear brothers and sisters, you may recall the Justice D.R. Singh judgment, which was delivered in 2007. In 2010, the Honorable Prime Minister in Debe Pinal mentioned that within 120 days in office, she would take the issues of the ex-Karani workers and finish with it. Today we are 5 years and we are less than 35% finished with our issues. And my dear brothers and sisters, one of our former colleagues and other ministers have been misleading our Prime Minister concerning the D.R. Singh judgment. We had explained the D.R. Singh judgment to an inter-ministerial meeting on the 26th of August 2014, and it was in that meeting it was decided that no ex-Karani worker was supposed to pay for a residential plot, and it was done by Mr. Nirvan Maharaj and the ex-Karani Workers Association, the Auxiliary General Workers Union. No government official did not give you that. I want to get that straight with you, my dear brothers and sisters. It sat in the government office and collected dust for 3 years, and it was only when we initiated that you may not pay, you will not have to pay for your BSEP package, that is when the government woke up. And it is an election time now, and they are waking up. And you, my dear brothers and sisters, must continue to keep waking up by supporting us at this level. My dear brothers and sisters, recently we had a meeting with Sugar Welfare concerning all those who had taken Sugar Welfare loan, BSEP recipients. We asked the government of Trinidad and Tobago to write off all those loans, because those loans were given to you on a criteria set out by Karani 1975 Limited and Sugar Welfare. So my dear brothers and sisters, that negotiation is on the way, where all Sugar Welfare loans are being contemplated to be written off. As a matter of fact, only on Wednesday, I got some information that 15 loans have been written off and they are contemplating on the rest. My dear brothers and sisters, we had also initiated a pension surplus which had been sitting for the last 10 years approximately, and no one knew about it. And you are entitled to that money on the 31st of May 2016. And we are asking the government of Trinidad and Tobago, we have given them the deadline in our last march on the 28th of March. We have given them the deadline of today's date, which is 23rd of May, whereby you should receive documentation when you will be paid that money. And we are calling on our beloved Prime Minister, my dear Prime Minister, please give us that documentation before the next general election. Because God forbid that the PNM win the next general election, we may never see this money again. And if this government wins the next general election, they may drag you on for more than 5 years again. And we have already our figures, official figures, by our land management unit coordinator, whereby 30%, my dear brothers and sisters, 30% of our ex-Karani workers has passed on and gone. 5 years more, another 40% might go. And we are asking, my dear brothers and sisters, of this government, please ensure that all ex-cane workers, cane farmers and squatters get what is due to them. My dear brothers and sisters, I want to bring to you our next speaker.